Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Everybody from young to old, and those who are especially invited guests, we want to welcome you here to the EMMC of Blue Creek's Christmas Eve program. And for those who are online and watching via live stream, welcome. And it's great to see such beautiful faces and people that are packed and ready to see what we have prepared tonight. I figured it would be a little bit soothing to start what off reading Luke chapter 2, which is the birth of Jesus. And that is what we're celebrating tonight. Luke chapter 2, verse 1 through 7. I'm going to read that for you this evening. And it goes this way. It says, "In those days, Caesar of Augustus issued a decree that a census should be taken of the entire Roman world. This was the first census that took place while Quirinius was the governor of Syria. And everyone went to his hometown to register. So Joseph also went up from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to Bethlehem, the town of David, because he belonged to the house and line of David. He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him and was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born. And she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in clothes and placed him in a manger because there was no room for them in the inn." So that was a couple thousand years ago. And I just want us to imagine a little bit for a moment what it might have been like during Jesus' birth. It was a town of Bethlehem, about perhaps 2,000 to 3,000 people, so a little bit bigger than Blue Creek. It was a quiet night, and they were going down for a census. And I thought a little bit, just to give a little bit of perspective, I see there's a lot of people that are from far, far away, and they're coming to their hometown to spend Christmas. It's not quite the same thing, but they're traveling from far, and they're going back to their hometown, where they came from, to visit their family. Perhaps they had family there, but they also had a census to be taken. And so tonight, couple thousand years later, we're celebrating that. We're celebrating the most beautiful, precious story, which is God coming down on earth. We're celebrating His coming down on earth and giving us a chance at redemption. And so tonight, we're celebrating that. And before we go into the program, I'd like to pause for a word of prayer. Why don't we start with a word of prayer? Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we come before you this evening. God, we thank you that you made yourself vulnerable and came down as a baby boy. And Father, we thank you that you chose to die for us and to take away the sin of the world. You didn't do it just you did it for everyone. Anyone who will believe and receive that gift that you have, that you brought down here on earth, Father. And Father, I just pray that tonight as we celebrate that, Father, we pray that our hearts would be open to that gospel message, that we would be open to hearing from you and how you minister through the things that we have this evening. We pray this in your precious name. Amen. So we're going to start off with a violin quartet, and then I'll ask those who are participating in the program that you just come on up, and I won't be coming up till after the end. So do enjoy the program. Thank you.
Thank you. and it's full. I hope it's comfortable. I hope you're comfortable. It is a night before Christmas, and we're all excited. I hope you're comfortable and ready to continue with our exciting program this evening. Several groups have prepared and are ready to speak to your heart in various ways this evening. I invite you to anticipate the Holy Spirit to comfort you and to inspire you on this special evening. There will be worship through song and portrayed through a skit presented by the youth. There will be a reminder to give back to God. There will be reflection through instrumental music as well. The choir will be coming up soon, but before they do, remind yourselves how it is celebrating year after year, soon adding more and more on your to-do list and filling up your already full schedule. One may suddenly realize the need to refocus on the reason for the season, which of course is setting apart specific time to meditate on the prophecy written in Isaiah chapter 7, verse 14. It says, "Therefore, the Lord himself will give you a sign. Behold, the virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and shall call his name Emmanuel." Emmanuel means God with us. I invite you to welcome Emmanuel into your heart and live your life so that others too can see that God is with us. How appropriate, how special for the season that we are in, celebrating. Celebrating the season of Emmanuel coming to earth as a baby. His arrival is not just a holiday for us. Rather, it was to ultimately express Christ's love for us, his sacrificial love. Ephesians chapter 5, verse 2 says, "And walk in love as Christ loved us and gave himself up for us, a fragrant offering and sacrifice to God." 1 John chapter 4, verses 9 and 10. "In this the love of God was made manifest among us, in that while we were still sinners, Christ died for us. In this love, not that we have loved God, but that he loved for us and sent us his Son to be the propitiation for our sins."
Singing carols of joy and peace, but you feel too far gone and too far out of reach. Somewhere in your silent night, heaven hears the song your broken heart has cried. Hope is here. Silent night.
When Christmas isn't a time of joy and peace, Christ can find you in your silent night. Emmanuel will meet you where you are. Psalms 34, verses 18 to 20 remind us of, the Lord is near to the brokenhearted and saves the crushed in spirit. Many are the afflictions of the righteous, but the Lord delivers him out of them all. He keeps all his bones, not one of them is broken.
Thank you. Thank you all for coming to our Christmas play. We hope you enjoyed it, and we just want to wish you all a
Merry Christmas.
All right, good job, guys. That was great. Remember to take your costumes downstairs, and remember which props you're supposed to take home. You got gold right there. Why are you trying to find some up there? And Rob, thank you so much for helping. I know it's a lot of time and work. And Jordan, you are a great shepherd. Thank you.
It's a step up from playing the donkey last year.
And Ellie, you're a wonderful wise man.
Thanks.
Where is Angela? I want to thank her too.
I think she was grabbing one of those gifts for us. Oh, look, here she is.
Kids, you did so great. And Dee, what a wonderful, wonderful job. It was so great. I cried.
She cries at commercials.
I do not. Okay, I do.
Can we go home and open presents now?
Yeah.
As soon as you get your coats off, get your costumes off, put your coats on.
Meet us at the front door. Christmas, it gets crazier every year.
I think Jordan just knocked over the coffee maker. Dee, Merry Christmas and a wonderful job.
Yes, I better go. The troops are getting restless. Merry Christmas, Dee.
Merry Christmas. Angela, your gift.
Oh, yes. See you next Sunday?
Yep, see you then. You're not riding home on that, are you?
Yep.
In this weather?
My dad needs a car and mom is, Grandpa's sick, so.
All right, just wait in the hall. I'll get you a ride.
All right.
Congratulations, Dee. Another success.
Thanks, and thanks for bringing Julia to practices so faithfully. Yeah, she's the best Mary I've ever seen.
Yeah, what do you say?
What?
Oh, thanks.
So, what are you doing now that your parents are around? Oh, I'm sorry, I shouldn't have brought it up.
Oh, no, it's fine. She just, well, she doesn't really like to talk about it much, and she doesn't really do anything nowadays besides just scrolling on Instagram.
But she loves to sing.
Yeah, but she loves her phone more right now. It helps her live in another world where she doesn't have to care about anyone or anything except for herself. She barely even looks up long enough to notice that mom and dad are gone. But I don't mean to bother you with this on Christmas Eve.
You know I don't mind.
I know you don't mind, but I do. I imagine your big house is going to be full of friends and family come tomorrow.
Oh, I wish. That would be nice.
Well, thanks again for all of your hard work. It was good for Julia to be part of it. Merry Christmas, Dee.
Merry Christmas. All right, guys, don't forget to get everything off stage. Who forgot to take Jesus?
Take off your shoes.
Hang up your coats.
I want to open this one.
I want this one.
Only one tonight. Santa will bring more in the morning.
Jordan, shoes.
I want to open this one too.
All right, go ahead and open them.
It's from Mom and Dad.
Mine too.
Oh man, polka dots?
I wanted a blue one.
Nobody wears polka dots, Mom.
All my friends have the blue one.
Polka dots make me look like a freak. I showed you the outfit I wanted.
I don't want to be the only one without a blue one.
All right, stop. Enough. What do you guys say?
Thank you.
Go get ready for bed.
I wanted the blue one.
Well, that was fun.
Didn't see that coming.
Didn't we?
Didn't we what?
See it coming? Last year, Jordan wanted a blue bike, but they didn't have blue, so we got in black. Ellie wanted a jean skirt, and we got her one, but it didn't have the right label, so it's hanging in the closet with the tags on. They complain about the color, the label, their chores too many, their allowances too small.
Jordan doesn't even ride his bike, even after we got him the black one.
Ellie has a closet full of clothes, half of which don't fit or she doesn't wear.
Yeah.
Robert, are our kids spoiled? They are, aren't they?
Yeah. Jordan doesn't even ride his bike, even after we got on the black one.
Ellie has a closet full of clothes, half of which don't fit or she doesn't wear.
I guess you can try to give a kid everything.
And they never learn how to give.
Give the gift back.
What, honey?
The preacher tonight at church told us to give the gift back. That's why he gave us this gift, to remind us that Jesus is the greatest gift of all time. We're supposed to give it back to the world.
So how can we give the gift back this Christmas?
I have an idea. Tomorrow when the kids are done with their opening their presents, we take all the clothes and toys they don't use anymore and put them in a bag.
That's a great idea. I think we should do it a bit too. I think Ellie gets her clothes hoarding from me.
And Jordan's love for all the newest toys comes from me.
Mom, Ellie pushed me.
You're such a baby. Go cry and tell Mommy.
Guys, come sit down. Andrew, can you pass me that Bible?
What are we doing?
We're going to read the Christmas story of the Bible the way it was supposed to be.
And after that, we'll tell you the plan for tomorrow.
What plan?
The plan to show you what Christmas is all about.
God sent the angel Gabriel to Nazareth to a virgin pledged to be married to a man named Joseph. The virgin's name was Mary.
Can I read the part about Mary?
Sure.
The angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary. You have found favor with God. You will give birth to a son, and you are to give him the name Jesus. The Holy Spirit will come upon you, so the Holy One to be born will be called the Son of God." Mary answered, "May it be to me as you have said." Do you want to read, Mom?
Sure. In those days, Caesar issued a decree that a census should be taken of the entire Roman world, and everyone went to his own town to register. So Joseph went to Bethlehem to register with Mary, who was pregnant at the time. While they were in Bethlehem, the time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to Jesus. She wrapped him up and placed him in a manger because there was no room for them in the inn.
Can I read?
Of course. Start right there.
After Jesus was born in Bethlehem, wise men came following a star in the sky that stopped over the place where Jesus was. They saw the child with his mother Mary and bowed down and worshipped him. Then they opened their treasure and presented him with gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. I like this story.
And the story of Jesus doesn't end with Christmas. Let's keep reading it.
And living it.
Hey, where are you going?
My room.
But it's Christmas Eve.
Yeah, so?
You know, we always open stockings on Christmas Eve.
No, that's what we used to do with Mom and Dad.
Julia?
Look, Liz, I don't want to. You can if you want to, but I'm going to my room.
No, you're not going to your room.
What?
You're not going to your room.
You're not my mom.
You're right. I'm not mom. And I'm not dad either. And I miss them too, Julia. But that doesn't give you or me a reason to be selfish.
I'm not selfish.
Oh, really? They gave us this gift at church. They said, give the gift back. And what did you do? You just threw it in the trash.
Leave me alone, Liz.
No, I won't leave you alone. Julia, you and Mom used to make sandwiches, dozens of sandwiches, every single week to take to the soup kitchen. You would write letters to our soldiers, you would help out in the church nursery, and you and Dad raised thousands of dollars in fundraisers for those homeless people in the city. And you and Mom, you were planning to go on a mission trip to Honduras?
Yeah, but that was with Mom and Dad, and they're not here anymore.
Julia. In those days, Caesar issued a decree that a census should be taken of the entire Roman world, and everyone went to his own town to register. So Joseph went to Bethlehem to register with Mary, who was pregnant at the time. While they were in Bethlehem, the time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to Jesus. She wrapped him up and placed him in a manger because there was no room for them in the inn. Why don't you keep reading?
There were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, watching over their sheep. And an angel of the Lord came to them and said, do not be afraid. I bring you good news of great joy that will be for all people. Today in Bethlehem, a Savior has been born to you. He is Christ the Lord. Then a host of heavenly angels appeared in the sky, praising God. And the shepherds said, let's go to Bethlehem and see. And they found Mary and Joseph with baby Jesus lying in the manger. When they had seen him, they told many people of the wonderful story of the angels and the birth of Jesus.
Julia, I know you miss Mom and Dad. And I know this Christmas is really hard for both of us without them. But Julia, Mom and Dad raised us to care for others, not just ourselves. And every year they would read us the Christmas story to remind us that, yeah, presents are nice and everything, but the greatest gift of all is God's Son, Jesus. And we lost a great gift when we lost Mom and Dad. But we have an even greater gift in Jesus. So this Christmas, let's share that gift with others around us. What do you think?
I always did like making sandwiches. Can we open stockings now?
Sure.
How'd it go?
Good, except there's this one kid who was picking his nose the whole time. It was a real little kid, though, so it's not like he knows any better.
How did you do?
Good. Well, I guess I was just a donkey, so I didn't have any lines or anything.
I'm sure you were great. It's almost Christmas.
Yep.
You excited?
I guess so.
I know this Christmas is going to be different with your mom. With your mom not here and no presents and all, but...
I don't need any presents.
I know you don't need presents, but all the same.
Is Dad gonna be home tomorrow?
I don't think so. He had to take a double shift at work so he could make more money with it being Christmas and all.
I understand. I don't see a donkey in here anywhere.
What you reading?
It's a Christmas story. Do you know what a manger is, Grandpa?
It's a feeding trough, isn't it?
Yeah, it's where the animals eat out of. And you know what?
What?
When Jesus was born, they laid him in that feeding trough like as if it was a cradle. Sometimes I feel like I'm living in a stable. I imagine it wasn't very comfortable for Jesus either. Right, Grandpa?
No, I imagine not.
Is that why he came like that, poor like us, so he'd know what it feels like?
Yes, I think that's why he came like that, so he would know how we feel. What you got there?
It's a gift. I got it at church. Well, there's nothing in it. They gave it to us to remind us that God gave us Jesus Christ as a gift so that we could give the gift back to people in need. I know we don't have a lot, but I'm sure there's people that have a lot less than us that we can help, right, Grandpa?
Yes, I think you're right. Why don't you head off to bed? It's late. You never know. Your dad might be here in the morning. You don't want to miss him.
Okay. Love you, Grandpa. Merry Christmas.
I love you, too. Merry Christmas, son.
No new messages.
Doesn't feel like Christmas. How can I give the gift back?
Hello, Joel? Yeah, it's Miss D. I know you and your grandpa might have plans tomorrow. Oh, yeah, okay. You and your grandfather might be busy tomorrow, but if not, I wanted to invite you over to Christmas dinner. Yeah, I can hold on a second. Oh, that's no problem. Yeah, I can pick you up and drop you both off. Oh, you can? Oh, good. Pick you up at 4:30 then? Oh, yeah, I can take you home too. Oh, great. All right. That's very sweet, but tell him he doesn't have to thank me. Pleasure is mine. All right, I'll see you tomorrow then. Okay, bye, Joel. Merry Christmas. Hey, Liz? Yeah, it's Dee. Merry Christmas to you, too. Hey, I was just wondering if you and Julia had plans for Christmas dinner tomorrow. Yeah, I will hold on a bit. Oh, really? Oh, that's great. See you at my house at around 5, then? Oh, that's great. And you know how to get here, right? Oh, that's sweet, but you don't have to. I got it all covered. All right, I'll see you both tomorrow, then. All right, Merry Christmas. Bye. Hey, Angela, it's Dee. I hope I'm not calling too late, but I was just wondering if you guys had any plans for tomorrow, and if not, I wanted to invite you over to my house for turkey, stuffing, and way too much pie. Yeah, I'll hold on. Oh, you will? That's great. I'm looking forward to it. At my house around 5, then? All right, that's great. No, I got everything covered for tomorrow. All right, looking forward to it. Yep, see you tomorrow. All right, Merry Christmas. Bye. Now it feels like Christmas.
For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only son on that first Christmas night. God sending his son was the greatest gift of all. And as Christians, we have been blessed with this gift. So as we reflect on the blessings we have received this Christmas, let us remember to give the gift back. Let God direct you in giving this gift back. Perhaps you know of someone that is missing a special person around the Christmas dinner table for the very first time this Christmas. Or perhaps you know of someone less fortunate. Whoever God directs you, let us just remember to give the gift back who needs it the most.
What a good portrayal of the importance of giving the gift of Jesus, the best gift of all. Like they read already, John 3:16 says, "For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have eternal life." God gave us the perfect gift when he gave us of himself, through the birth of Jesus. What a joy it is to keep on giving.
In a manger we have found our mighty King.
Jesus' light came breaking through the darkness. Wake your hearts with heaven singing joy to the world. He is the Messiah. Messiah, on our knees we fall, a baby born to save us all. This is what Christmas is, giving the true gift, the gift of God's salvation, which was first given to us many years ago. Because of Christ, the event which happened all those years ago is still relevant and current for today. It is all because of Him. We have hope for a better world, all because of Him. Our response is similarly found in Isaiah chapter 6, verse 3, and in Revelation chapter 4, verse 8b, where it says, "Holy, holy, holy is the Lord of hosts. The whole earth is full of His glory. Holy, holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty, who was and is to come." The last choir song sings, "My heart can't help but sing, with all of heaven roar, forever echo, holy is the Lord."
Ever shelter. gathered at the highest throne, welcomed by a melody, an anthem I have always known, a song that's always been in me. All glory and honor, dominion and power to you. Before the throne of grace, majesty before my eyes, let it take my breath away.
Thank you. Testing. Für das letzte Lied, weil wir Friedensfürst singen. Und ich kriege irgendwem nach, wem nicht Janka zu singen. So, wenn ihr sagt, ich bin praktisch, ihr wisst oder nicht, you're welcome to come and join. Das ist ein bisschen Tradition-Song, dass wir irgendwer können abkommen, halten und singen. So, anybody is invited to come and join us.
Well, that comes to the end of our program tonight. Why don't we give another round of applause to all of those who have made the effort and time to put this together. And let us remember this Christmas that we have been blessed with the greatest gift of all, which is Jesus coming here on earth. And I just want to extend that invitation to anyone who has never received that gift, that don't put it off another Christmas. Don't put it off another day. Receive that gift of salvation that only Jesus can offer. And for a couple of announcements, I just want to invite all youth that are here tonight. We're going to be, after this program, we're going to do some Christmas caroling. So don't run away. We want to do some Christmas caroling. We'll be meeting at the credit union. And we'll make a couple of stops. We're going to stop at the retirement home and also at the Edenthal Park. After that, youth, we're going to have some snacks, some s'mores. I hope I don't disappoint, but I think we're going to have some s'mores and some snacks, hot chocolate, and a wonderful time and welcome the Christmas morning. We're going to go up till late. So, all right. Before we go from here, why don't we end off this evening with a word of prayer. Heavenly Father, we just thank you once again that you have sent your Son here to die on the cross. And Lord God, I just pray that as we celebrate Christmas, whether it is through food and fellowship, Father, I pray that you would be with us in our conversations. And Father, I just pray that for all those that are here tonight, Father, that you would bless each and every one of the people that have come out this evening. And Lord God, we just want to thank you once again for dying on the cross for us. Let's pray in your precious name. Amen. All right. Merry Christmas and have a good night.